y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be my everyday makeup drawer. I'm gonna start doing these maybe like bi-weekly or once a month, showing you what's in front, you know, this little table that y'all don't see that I film in front of, has a drawer in it. And this is where I put products that I kind of use every day or products I wanna, you know, get more use out of. So I normally put them in here or new products that I'm liking. So like I said, I wanna try doing this maybe once a month or bi-weekly, depending on, you know, what's in here or if it's just the same stuff over and over. Obviously, I want to show you guys that again, so I'm going to try and switch it out more often, and you know, that'll give me some motivation to put some new stuff in here. So I hope you guys do enjoy this video. Make sure to subscribe before you leave, give it a thumbs up, and comment down below a drugstore item you've been loving recently. No matter if it's skincare, it could be a mask, could be, you know, eyeshadow, mascara, just something you've been loving. I want to test out some new products, so just let me know and let's just go ahead and get started. So this is my everyday makeup drawer right here. This is the little table that I film on that you guys normally don't see, but this is what the inside of the drawer looks like. I did this a video like this probably a month or two ago, but I want to do an updated one. This little insert right here and divider is from IKEA. And then I just have some tape over here for eyeshadows, a speaker, and some baking sponges I normally bake with. But let's just go ahead and start with the products. So I have this Ulta Fabulous Face face powder in here. I normally will use this to set my face in the morning before school. It's a really nice powder and it's really silky and soft. Next, I have one of these EOS lip balms. This one is in Lemon Drop. I'm just wanting to use it more, and I normally apply a lip balm prior to leaving before school because I normally don't wear lipstick or anything, so I just want to keep my lips hydrated. These are okay. Sometimes I feel like if I use them too much, it actually makes my lips chapped. Next, I have this little Coastal Scents blush and a bronzer palette. I actually mentioned this in my February favorites video, so I will link that down below or put a card. But this is amazing for travel, and I love using it on an everyday basis because it has a matte bronzer, shimmer bronzer, two extremely pigmented blushes, and one really pretty highlight. So it's real easy for me to gravitate towards in the mornings because it's like an all-in-one palette and it's real easy to use. Next thing I have right here is this Becca Ultimate Coverage Concealer. This is in the shade Banana. I'm not a huge fan of pot concealers, but I wanted to give this one some more love because the coverage is insane. It definitely, you know, needs to be set very fast and blended out with a sponge, but it's very thick and tacky. So I'm just trying to get some more use out of it, show it some love, figure out if I love it or like it or, you know, hate it. Next is a lipstick. This is the Maybelline Matte Lipstick in 657 in Nude Nuance. This is a really pretty kind of darker brownie red shade. Really love this for the fall, but it is currently raining here in Texas. That's why my lighting situation is not the best, but you know, I'll still wear this even in the spring because it's just a really gorgeous matte shade. Next, I have two of the Wet n Wild Catsuit liquid lipsticks that I have not opened yet because they are brand new colors to me. One is Nudist Peach and one is Give Me Mocha. These are an amazing, amazing formula. I have the Rebel Rose shade that I absolutely love, and I wanted to pick up two new shades. These are the two new shades that I landed on, and I think they're gorgeous. I can't wait to actually try them out. Now, moving on to this little section right here, I have my e.l.f. Tone Adjusting Face Primer in green. This definitely doesn't make the biggest difference when it comes to redness, but it's drugstore, it's okay, so I just put it in here because I'm trying to use it up. Next, I have the e.l.f. Acne Fighting Foundation with salicylic acid in it. I did a first impression over this, which it will probably be up before this, but oh my gosh, this is amazing. It's completely full coverage and it is gorgeous. The shade is a little dark for me, but there's nothing I can do about it because they don't make a lighter shade. So e.l.f., if you're watching this, which you're probably not, I highly, highly would suggest that you make a bigger shade range in this because this is awesome. I have right here the City Color Shimmer Highlight, and this is just one of their powder highlights. This is really nice. I actually filmed a video using it today and it gives a nice, pretty iridescent look. So I definitely have it in here for everyday use. I have my Milani Rose Blush in 08T Rose. This just needs some more love. I've had it sitting in my blush drawer for a while now. I haven't used it, so I stuck it in here, and isn't it just so pretty? I love how it has a rose on the powder. Like, that's so pretty. It looks luxurious. Like, you would think that would be expensive, but it's like only $8. Next I have right here is the e.l.f. Eyebrow Kit. This is their wax and I believe a powder. And this is actually not too bad. Like, I could probably compare it to the Benefit Browsings. They're a little compact. This is really nice. It gets the job done and I really, really like it. So I'm still testing it out, so I'll let you know in a future video my exact thoughts. Right here I have an eyeliner that I've been liking. This is the Essence Gel Eye Pencil and this is a gel liner, and let me tell you, I have some watery eyes and I can't ever figure out an eyeliner that can actually stay in my waterline, but this guy does. It's amazing. It's Essence, so it's only like $2 or $3. In the second compartment right here, I have my Rimmel Stay Matte Pressed Powder. I normally will use this in the morning before school just to keep me looking matte and flawless throughout the day. Depending on how my skin is or if I have any dryness, will depend if I use like this Rimmel powder or the Ulta one. Next I have is the Maybelline Brow Precise Fiber Volumizer Brow Mascara. And this one is in, what shade is this in? Oh, it's in blonde. And this stuff is so cool compared to the other one. I actually have the original one back here. This is just the Sculpting Brow Mascara in soft brown. This one, the packaging is real cute and reflective, but the cool part about it is the wand has fibers in it, so it actually runs through the toothbrush. It grips onto your brows, and as you're moving it through your brows, it disperses the brow color gel and also the fibers to make them appear thicker, which it does. So I definitely like this one over the original mascara, but they both are still really great. Next right here I have the Wet n Wild Color Icon Blush in Rose Champagne. These are amazing blushes for only $3 or $4. They're the most pigmented blush I could probably assume from the drugstore, considering I've tried a lot. These are really pretty. The shade is gorgeous. It's a really pretty, you know, everyday nude shade. You can pair with any look, a, you know, pretty dramatic smoky eye, or just an everyday, you know, concealer and mascara look. Next, I have the most talked about bronzer probably of 2016. This is the Butter Bronzer from Physicians Formula. Pretty much everybody and their mother has this in their collection because it's great and it smells amazing. I keep it in here because I do use it sometimes on an everyday basis because I love the shade of it. And they do have two shades. Mine is in bronzer and they have a light bronzer, which is lighter than this, but it's amazing. It's so silky and smooth and it smells like a tropical getaway. And last thing right here I have is the Makeup Revolution Vivid Baked Highlighter. And this is in Golden Lights. This almost has like a duochrome kind of finish because when you rub it on and then you rub it like, not rub it in light, but it hits light, it has like a kind of a white and gold tint to it. Obviously you wouldn't put it, you know, that intense on your cheekbones, but it's really pretty and it's, you know, obviously very pigmented. So they have like two or three other shades from this line I really want to try. And over here in this little compartment, I have the L'Oreal Glam Bronzer in 01 Light. I believe this was limited edition. I don't think that they sell it anymore, but don't worry, you're not really missing out on much. This bronzer's okay. It's not amazing. It definitely has shimmer in it and it's just not my favorite. You know, I have other bronzers that I do prefer more, like the Butter Bronzer, so it's just not my favorite, but I did buy it, so of course I will use it. That's why it's in here. Then I have my favorite concealer of all time. This is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in a 10 Light. I have yet to find a drugstore concealer that can top this for me. It's not drying. It's a full coverage. You can put it on top of anything and it looks amazing. That's why I always keep it in here and I have a backup. Then I have a mascara and a brow pencil. This is the Maybelline Brow Define in a Fill Duo, and this was in blonde. Has a pencil on one side and then a powder on the other. No spoolie, which, you know, kind of sucks because you have to go with the spoolie separately. This is a really nice product. I've only used it once, so I don't have, you know, my complete thoughts on it yet, but it is a really nice product so far. And then this right here is a mascara from MAC. This is the MAC Zoom Lash Mascara. This mascara is okay. The only thing I don't like at all is if you put on your bottom lashes, it does transfer below, which obviously I don't like. I also had that same problem with the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, but the waterproof version, the normal version's great, but the waterproof does that. So I won't repurchase this again because I just don't like it. That's why it's in here and I'm trying to use it up. Last two things I have right here, a concealer and a mascara. This is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser of Dark Circles. This is in Fair. I didn't realize how amazing this was because I bought the wrong thing. I actually bought the foundation of this and I was like, why is this so great? Like, people rave about this and this stuff looks horrible. And then I'm like, oh my gosh, because I'm using the wrong thing. Like, I don't even know what I was doing, but I finally got the right thing and now I understand why, because this is so full coverage and it's amazing. That's why it's in here, because I normally will just wear it to school. And then I have the NYX Le Frou Frou Mascara. This is a drugstore mascara that I did get on sale. It's really not that great. I'm putting it in here because I'm trying to get use out of it, because I really want to get rid of it because it's taking up space. Then the last little drawer back here, some new things I'm trying out. This is the Too Faced Peanut Butter and Jelly Palette. This is probably the cutest freaking palette I've ever seen, and the color selection is amazing for every day. I did film a tutorial with this. It's probably going to be up before or after this. Not 100% sure, but I will link it down below. And this is just amazing. It smells like peanut butter and the shades are pigmented and gorgeous. Then I have the Maybelline The Colossal Big Shot Mascara. This, I had high hopes for this, but actually I wasn't that impressed by it. It didn't really give me too much volume. It actually lengthened my lashes more than volume, and I have other mascaras that do length and volume at the same time. So this is nice. I love the packaging and it's a cool idea. But, you know, like most mascara commercials, they're normally wearing false lashes, so it's hard to get an actual, you know, say on how good a mascara is when you're looking at a TV commercial about it. But, like I said, it gave more length and volume, so it's kind of like an mascara for me. Then I have this Laura Geller Baked Blush. This is in Pink Buttercream. It's a real pretty everyday kind of color. And I put it in here because I have it in my acrylic organizer. I had it in there and I forgot about it, so I never used it. So I stuck it in here that way I could get some more love. And the last thing I have in here is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighting Powder in Crown of My Canopy. This thing is gorgeous. I did a testing new makeup products video using this and it's just gorgeous. I mean, look at the reflectiveness. That's just amazing. If you ever see any of these highlighters or the Precious Petals one, highly recommend picking it up. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video of my everyday makeup drawer. If you want to see, like I said, a monthly thing of this, just let me know in the comments or give this video a thumbs up. I hope you guys did enjoy. Thanks so much for watching. I will have all the products and everything down below, so make sure to check there if you're interested in any of them, and I will see you guys later. Bye guys.